Guys, welcome to Career Launcher. In this video, we would learn a very important topic of chemical equilibrium, that is law of mass action. So let us begin. So what a law of mass action is? It is one of the laws of chemical equilibrium that is help to determine how much of the reactant would get converted into a product. So this is like a very big mystery that we can understand or learn about how much of the reactant would get converted into product using this law. So what will be the concentration of reactants and products at equilibrium? That is another important question, or how this composition can be altered. All these such queries or doubts can be understood by using this law of mass action. So you must know that every reaction is almost every reaction of this world is a reversible reaction. It follows law of chemical equilibrium. There would be a point of equilibrium where some of the reactant would be remaining and some of the product has been formed. So after this point, the amount of the concentration of R will also not change, and the concentration of product will also not change. The reaction might be going on, the reactant might be getting converted into product, and product then some of the product might be getting into converted into reactant again. So at this point, there would not be change of the concentration of either of reactant nor of product, nothing else apart from this. So let us consider a reaction represented by this thing. A plus B B gives C moles of C and D moles of D. So what would happen at equilibrium? Will only C and D be present, or A B C D all things will be present? So as I said earlier, reactant and product both would be present and their concentration would be also be fixed. So at equilibrium, concentrations are related by the following relations. So this is Kc. Kc is known as equilibrium constant. Then it is given as number of moles of C, that is one of the product, to the power of small c, that is its stoichiometric coefficient, and multiplied by D, number of moles of other product, that is to the power of its stoichiometric coefficient, is divided by concentration of A, that is one of the reactant, and concentration of B raised to their respective stoichiometric coefficient. So the thing that has to be kept in mind is these all the units of this had to be same. Here it is mole per liter, then concentration would be mole per liter here also, and by that we would determine the unit of Kc. So level of chemical, so this is what we have obtained till now. Kc is equal to this. So what are the laws of chemical equilibrium? At a given temperature, the product of concentrations of the reactant products raised to the respective stoichiometric coefficient in the balanced chemical equation divided by those of products would be constant, and the product of concentration, so same thing, the product of concentration of the reactants raised to their individual stoichiometric coefficient has a constant value. This is nothing, this complete statement is nothing but this. This is the statement 1 and this is the statement 2. So this is the law of a very important law of chemical equilibrium that would be used everywhere in the chapter of chemical equilibrium. So now let us understand by an illustrative problem or an example. If Kc is equilibrium constant for this equation or this reaction, determine the equilibrium constant for this reaction, that is C moles of C is a stoichiometric coefficient, C plus D gives A plus B in this ratio, and then this Na, that is number of moles of A or the stoichiometric coefficient of A, and then this the stoichiometric coefficient NB is of B and gives a product C and D. So let us solve this. Solution you can see on your screen. What is Kc? Kc is equilibrium constant for this. So it can be written what we learnt earlier. This is nothing, that formula we have used earlier. Let me change the color for your ease. Okay. Now for this reaction, CCDD plus AABB, what would be it? I hope you can understand what I am writing. This is a concentration, take it as concentration symbol A upon concentration of reactant to the power of stoichiometric coefficient, concentration of other reactant to the power of its stoichiometric coefficient. So what is it? It is nothing but 1 upon Kc. So it is here. So K dash is 1 upon Kc, that you can see here we have obtained. Now for Na, now for the third reaction, similarly we can obtain K double dash, and it can be written in this manner. It is nothing again number of moles of product or the concentration of products raised to their stoichiometric coefficient divided by number concentration of reactants raised to their respective stoichiometric coefficient. So K double dash is obtained in this manner and can be taken common from all. So what is it? It is nothing but C, or this thing is written here. So it is Kc to the power n. So K double dash becomes Kc to the power n. So for this we have obtained here, and for this it is here. So it is very easy to obtain the equilibrium constant. Now for you, I am taking other example where we have some actual reactants and products. Calculate the equilibrium constant for the reaction H2 plus CO2, both are in the gaseous form with 1:1 of stoichiometric coefficient, gives us H2O in gaseous form and CO in gaseous form at 1395 Kelvin. This is very important in every chemical equilibrium reaction. At what temperature is the reaction happening? So if the equilibrium constant at 1395 Kelvin for the following are this. I am saying it to be very important again, because when I mentioned what is a Kc, I clearly mentioned there that it is at a particular temperature. Kc would change with temperature here at a given temperature. So if a statement comes that it at different temperature, there might be different Kc. So the first reaction I am writing, reaction is given as 2H2O gives 2H2 plus O2 with K1 equal to this, 2CO2 gives 2CO plus O2 K2 equal to this. So if I combine both reactions, what they have done, see, 2H2 plus O2 is 2H2O, just we have reversed this. So here what is happening, when I reverse, I just shown you that K dash becomes 1 upon Kc when the reaction was reversed. So K3 or K dash is 1 upon K1, that is nothing, K1 is this, and the reciprocal of it would be this Kc for this reaction. And 2CO2 gives 2CO plus O2, similarly say it is written as same, K2 would be this. Now for this reaction, I am taking 2H2 plus 2CO2 gives 2H2O plus 2CO. So what is happening here? Are we adding these two reactions? Yes, right, we are adding these two reactions here, 2H2 plus 2CO2, and O2 is getting cancelled, 2H2O, 2CO. So what would the K4? Whenever we add two reactions, the Kc for the third obtained reaction is nothing but the product of previous two Kc. This is another rule of chemical equilibrium or method used to obtain the values of Kc. So what is K4 here? Using these things, K3 into K2, that is equal to K2 upon K1. So K4 is H2O, concentration of H2O to the power 2, because everywhere it is 2 here, so all are raising to the power 2, that is equal to K2 by K1, what I mentioned here. So K required is nothing but under root of K4, as here it is, sorry, it should be this, let me check, K4 is this, K2 by K1, sorry, this is right. But K required, yes, K required is K4 to the power half, because it is to the power 2, and actually here there is no 2 here. So if we are removing any stoichiometric coefficient throughout the reaction, it is used in the power of that equilibrium constant. So it is K2 by K1. K required is 140 by 21, K2 by K1. K2 is 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 12. Upon 2.1 into 10 to the power minus 13, so it becomes into 10, that is 14 by 2.1, that can be written as 140 by 21 and to the power half. So K required becomes under root 20 by 3, that is equal to 2.58. So this is how we solve this problem. So thank you for watching the video. If you have any queries regarding this topic, do drop in the comment section.